Let's bring in Paul Hamilton, who covers the Buffalo Sabres. And Paul, Buffalo is wrapping up a 7-game homestand. So before the Sabres head out on the road, what's the focus tonight to make sure they wrap up this homestand on a high note?
Well, it's huge for them. I don't think you can come home for 7 games and just be .500. And that's what they would be if they lose to the New York Rangers tonight. They would only have 7 points. A victory would give them 4-2-1. They would then have 9 points, give them some confidence as they head to New Jersey, Florida, and Tampa for a 3-game road trip. So I think it's very, very important for this team to be able to win the game, get their 9 points. Now, you were just talking about last year, that victory over the Islanders the other night puts them 1 point ahead of last year's point total already, and we're in the middle of February. But they want to stay in this playoff race, and I think that's what makes tonight very important.
Yeah, and as Butch just said, the Sabres went through a long stretch where they were giving up a ton of goals, but now they've only given up 5 goals in their last 3 games. So how have you seen the defense improve?
Well, they had a 6-5 overtime loss to Carolina, where Carolina basically every goal they had, there was a wide open player. And Phil Housley said afterwards, we have to make it tougher in front of our net. And his defensemen and his forwards responded. There was no longer a discord. They're knocking people down in front of the net. They're making sure folks are covered and earning their goals. They're not having those tap-ins or anything like that. So it's really been a defensive effort together the last 3 games, which is something they hadn't had for a long time. But Phil Housley finally convinced them that if they're going to win, that's the way they're going to have to do it.
And you know, a Hall of Famer like Phil Housley loves to see a better defensive effort, I'm sure. With the trade deadline just 10 days away, though, what do you think the Sabres' approach will be, and what does Jeff Skinner's future look like in Buffalo?
Well, Jeff Skinner loves playing in this market, and he was on the NHL Network with you guys at the All-Star Game, and I'd spent some time with him before that, and he really enjoys playing in a hockey market. And he didn't realize, being a visitor to Buffalo, what kind of fans that were here. And now that he's been here, he has really enjoyed it, and I think he would like to stay if it's all possible. I wouldn't look for Jason Botterill to even think about trading him at the trade deadline. Now, he would have to approve any trade. He has no movement, but I don't even think he'll be approached. The sense I get is that Jason Botterill wants to play this right till the end, and he can get an 8-year deal if he waits till after the trade deadline. I don't think Jason Botterill's worried about it. The discussions are going well, but I do not think they're looking to trade him at all. I think they're looking to play this out and get him signed to a contract.
Well, certainly Sabres fans, that is music to their ears. Jeff Skinner has been an immediate and natural fit there in Buffalo. Paul, thanks so much. Enjoy the game tonight.
Thanks for having me.